I want to talk about transcription and translation today, but maybe not in the way you expect. I want to talk about the process of making stuff. Things don't just magically appear in cells, or in life, actually. And we are going to practice transcription, translation, and look at the activation of the human insulin gene to see how everything works. Now, if you want to know about the physiology of insulin and how it works, I have some videos about that. I am assuming some basic knowledge of animal cells and the organelles. Today's focus will be pancreatic beta cells. Those are the ones that produce insulin. Now, a theme here is no magic, only mechanism. Insulin doesn't just magically appear like poof in the cells of the pancreas. I've got an analogy. It's penguins, of course. So penguin gifts don't just magically appear in your office or bedroom. Actually, for me, they kind of do, but just go with me on this. We start with a shipping box. The shipping box gets the gift where it needs to go, but you don't keep the box. Inside the box, you have bubble wrap or some kind of packing material. You don't keep that either. In order to use the gift, you have to take away those other things, and you end up with your penguin gift. Yay! So cute. Now, we have some standardized nomenclature here. Go with me on this. We start with the box. We call the shipping box a pre-pro-penguin. Say that fast 5 times. The bubble wrap version of the penguin we call the pro-penguin, and then the penguin in its final form we just call penguin. So this is just a standardized naming system. Pre-pro-X contains a signal or leader sequence. This is going to be the box with the shipping label that makes sure the product gets to the right place, usually the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Pro-X refers to the precursor of the final product. In our analogy, this was the bubble wrap around the penguin. And finally, X. This is the final active protein, or in the analogy, the penguin gift, which you can now use. So the making of insulin has multiple steps. We start with pre-proinsulin, then proinsulin, then insulin. So you notice things are getting removed here. The sequence is getting shorter. Now, don't come at me with the actual numbers. It varies a little bit. The exact numbers are not important. Just focus on the big picture. So again, standardized nomenclature. To make a hormone, we start with a pre-pro hormone. Then we have a pro hormone, and finally the active hormone. Okay, so other examples. You try. Somatostatin. What would we start with? Pre-pro-somatostatin. And then? Yes, pro-somatostatin. How about one more? Glucagon. Pre-pro-glucagon. And then? Pro-glucagon. Yeah, it's weird, but not hard. By the way, from this, we can make things like GLP-1 and 2. You've probably seen these in the news lately with drugs like Ozempic. Okay, let's do it. Transcription, translation, and activation of insulin. Here are the players in this story. I like to think about the nucleus as the headquarters. The rough ER and the ribosomes will be the production center, and the Golgi will be the packing and distribution center. Let's look at the process. Here we go. Transcription from DNA to messenger RNA. Specifically, again, we are looking at the INS gene, INS for insulin, in humans on chromosome 11. This is the original blueprint. This is the gene. This is kept safely in the nucleus. It's way too precious to let the DNA out into the cytoplasm because the cytoplasm is a very dangerous place. So in order to use this gene, we make a copy of it. This process is called transcription, and the copy is called a transcript. The transcript is messenger RNA. Now, both DNA and messenger RNA are similar. They're both written in the same language, but they look a little bit different. You've probably seen these differences before. Double-stranded versus single-stranded, deoxyribose versus ribose. Okay, but for our purposes today, and to make the transcript, you need to notice this. In DNA, we have the base thymine, but in mRNA, we have uracil instead. So we're going to practice transcription. We're going to go from DNA, and I want you to come up with the messenger RNA transcript. This is so easy. All you do is replace every thymine with a uracil. Ready? So try it. ATG. What do you get? AUG. You just replace the T with a U. Next, GCC. What do you get? Same. GCC. CTG. What do you get? C-U-G. And finally, T-G-G. What do you get? U-G-G. And that's it. I told you. It's not difficult. So again, transcription is happening in the nucleus. We're making the transcript. You just did the first 4. I'll go ahead and do the rest. Whew, that's a lot. Nice. Now you've made a copy which can leave the nucleus. And if it's destroyed, it doesn't matter. You still have the original. By the way, if you find this video helpful, can you show me some love and take a second? Doesn't cost you anything. Just click some buttons below. It makes a huge difference on my end so I can keep making videos like this for you. Thanks. Okay, now we're going to translate that mRNA. That mRNA is going to move out to a ribosome. I know you know the word translation. It refers to changing languages. So we're going to go from nucleotide language to amino acid language. That means we're going to need a dictionary. It's the dictionary of life. Are you ready? Okay, we can look at it in table form or in a wheel. I prefer a wheel, but I'm going to show you both. For example, we have the codon CGU. We need to translate that into an amino acid. So we start with the first base, which is C, the second base is G, and the third is U. And you see what we get there is arginine. So CGU in the messenger RNA translates to the amino acid arginine. And here's arginine. This is what it looks like. Okay, I actually prefer the wheel. So let's try that. We have C, G, and U. And that gives us arginine again. Well, that's a good thing. They both work. Okay, so we've got the mRNA transcript for preproinsulin, and I want you to translate the first four codons. Don't worry, I'll help. First codon is AUG. So we go AUG. That's methionine. That actually means start. Next, we have GCC. G, C, and C. That translates to alanine. CUG. C, U, G. That gives us leucine. And U, G, G. That gives us tryptophan. So that's how you translate. So you just did the first four. I'll do the rest. This is preproinsulin. Insulin with the shipping box and the bubble wrap. Now, preproinsulin will move to the rough endoplasmic reticulum. That's actually what that signal sequence dictates. That's what the shipping box tells us. So in the rough ER, this signal peptide, which I've shown in yellow, is going to be cleaved off. It's going to be removed. Its job is done. And this leaves us with proinsulin. Now we have the penguin in the bubble wrap. From here, proinsulin will go to the Golgi for the last step. Now in the Golgi, another sequence will be cleaved and proinsulin will become insulin. And we're left with two chains, the A chain and the B chain, linked by disulfide bonds. This is what it actually looks like. So we have the A chain in blue and the B chain in green. Here's one disulfide bond, and here's the other disulfide bond. And you probably noticed there's a disulfide bond here within the A chain itself. And as the whole protein wraps and takes on its full three-dimensional shape, this is what you get, the functional protein insulin. In summary, hopefully today you understand why this is an oversimplification of cell production processes. Today we started with the INS gene in the nucleus. You helped to make a transcript, a copy, in the form of messenger RNA for preproinsulin. That transcript went out to a ribosome and was translated. Now we're in the language of amino acids. Preproinsulin then went to the rough ER, and in the rough ER, the signal peptide, that is the shipping label, was cleaved off, leaving you with proinsulin, like insulin with bubble wrap. Proinsulin moves to the Golgi, where the final cleavage occurs. We remove that bubble wrap, leaving us with the active hormone insulin, which will be ready to export and use to help control blood glucose. As always, I hope that was helpful. Thank you so much for visiting the Penguin Prof channel. Please show me the love, click those buttons below, and I will see you in the next one. Good luck.